All of you?
Hi, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Yes. So, shall we start the session then?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, so two more people have joined us now. Okay. Anybody else? Okay, as and when they join, we'll... Okay, guys. So, we'll start a session now. Okay. As you remember, last time, we were talking about branding. Okay. And we saw two videos on branding and one on positioning. Right? So what is a brand?
Yes,
if I should ask you, what's a brand? What do you think is a brand? What is your perspective about a brand?
Quality.
Quality? Okay.
The value others give.
The value others give. Exactly. Then? What else do you think is a brand? Quality, the
making
value.
Unique
making
a unique idea compared to other marketing
product manufacturers.
Okay, making a unique identity for your product. Okay, then? Very good. Yes, anybody else? So what is a brand?
It's like a product manufactured by a company under a particular name.
Yes, product manufactured in a company under a particular name. Okay, so all of us have a different perspective about brand, right? Some of you say it's a product. Some of you are saying it's about the quality of product. Some of you are saying it's about the value we give to a product, right? And we also discussed about the same in the last class. For some of you who are absent, I would like to revisit certain topics we covered last class. We discussed from that video that your brand is what people say about you when you're not in the room. A very popular person that told this was Jeff Bezos. So brand is what people say about you when you're not in the room. What does that mean? It's a very deep statement, right? So in your press, So it is? Yes. Even without your presence, what people feel about your product, what people feel about your service. Okay. And something more we talked about that day was, we talked, the brand is a representation of a company's values, purpose, aesthetic, passion, and place. Okay. Brand is not just about a logo, a brand statement, a punchline. Okay. It is not about that. Brand is about what values company hold dear, what purpose the company exists for. Okay. What, how is the company placing itself among its competitors? How uniquely it is providing its product or services? That is about brand. We also discuss about how it is the image of your company in the eyes of your customers. Okay. We discuss about that. So in the eyes of your customer, okay, it's image of your company in the eyes of your customer. It's a very deep statement. We discuss about it. What? How do you create a good image for your products?
Without your present in the class, somebody is talking about your brand.
Yeah. If it is about me, even without my presence, somebody should be able to talk. If tomorrow I am not in the university, somebody should list me, right? Okay. That would be a brand I would have created. Now, what about your product? It is the image of your company in the customer's eyes. So how do you create an image, good image about your company or your product? When do you create a good image about your product?
Build a trust factor, sir.
Build a trust factor, okay. Then, how else do you create it? Somebody in the last class said, build a product with quality, right? When you build a product with quality, you create a brand image. Right? Yeah. Now it is the image of a company in the customer's eye. Okay. Quality. So if you have to deliver a product with quality, what does quality mean? When do you say a product has
standard,
a particular quality? Standard. Okay. Then?
Differ from other products.
Differ from other products. Okay. When do you say that your product has good quality or the product that you use has good quality? When do you give that quality stamp on? If the people choose that product, then, okay, then In simple words, if the product meets its promises, you say it has good quality, right? If it does not meet its promises that the product kept about its quality, you won't say it has the quality, right? That's why you choose branded items over other things, right? Yeah. So that is as simple as an image. You know, you create your image based upon your quality, but quality is keeping promises. Okay. So going backward, keeping promises and delivering on your quality creates a brand image for a product or a service. Okay. So you want to create a good image in the eyes of your customer, create a product with good quality. Quality means by keeping promises. Okay. Yeah. So another statement is, a brand is the impression that a customer has of you, your company and your product. We discussed last time, and we have discussed this often in the class. Why do people always choose Apple products? Right? Now, why is Srivasagam using iPhone when he had option of using so many different phone? If I should ask Srivasagam, why are you using an iPhone?
Brand. I prefer it much better. Yeah. Good.
Why do you prefer it over the other phones?
I'm already using Android.
Yeah.
I'm already using Android also, sir. But iPhone is different compared to Android.
So in what way is it different?
It's not very. It's using for only commercial purpose, not for a gaming other things. It's only
commercial purpose. You prefer iPhone? Okay, Ben.
Of course.
Why does somebody pay even three times the more cost on an iPhone and purchase it? Adarsh also has an iPhone, right? What do you think, Adarsh?
Of course, today's most of the people need camera quality something.
Okay.
Prefer iPhone.
Okay. What does iPhone give you?
Actually, I'm using commercial purpose. That's
commercial. Okay. So Thiru is using for commercial purpose. Why do most of the people use an iPhone?
Insecurity, I think.
Security. Okay.
Much security.
Okay. Security features are
maybe
better.
The big brand.
It's a big brand. So when you use an iPhone, how do you look in other's eyes?
It's a little bit big status, like
it has a status symbol to you, right? Okay, so actually, when you have an Apple product in your hand, whether it is an iPhone or an iPad, there's a status symbol that is attached to you, right? Does an Apple product make you feel better? Does an Apple phone make you feel better? Now, that is what is called as a brand. It is not only about the product you give or the services you give, but how you make others feel with your product or service is what is called as a brand.
Okay.
So what startup you have in your mind? All of you have different type of startups. It is not important. It is important, of course, the product and the services you give. But when you give those products and services, how does the customer feel about it? How does your customer feel about your product and services more important than what you give? Okay. One other statement goes like this: people buy your story, not your product alone. Okay. So brand is about it. What impression, what perception do you create in the minds of your customer? Okay. Let's go ahead. Have you heard about Simon Sinek's Golden Circle? Has anybody heard about it?
No.
Yeah. Now, Simon Sinek is actually an author. He's a good motivational talker. Talker, and he actually has a lot of content online. You can go and search. Now, he actually studied different successful companies. Apple is one of those companies. And he tried to understand their thought process. How does these companies think and operate? And then he came up with this concept called the Golden Circle, which is a thought process that most of these companies put in to identify their brand statement, or to create their brand value. And one of the thought process that he said can be agreed is using this Simon Sinek's Golden Circle. Now, most of you, when you were discussing with me about your startup idea, for example, when Adarsh and Roshni were talking to me about their startup idea, what did you talk about first? Yes? What did you talk, Adarsh, what was your idea?
Kebab, sir. Kebab.
So you said what you would make, right? I want to make kebab. What is the second thing you started discussing with me?
Momos.
Yes? No, that's fine. Momos, kebab sir. And momo. But what is the second thing? You started talking to me about the process, right?
Yeah, for
how would you make this kebab? How would you get that specific type of stuff with charcoal, coal and all those things? Yes? So yeah. You started talking to me about your thing. What are you going to do? What do you want to do? What you want to make kebab? Okay. Now, how do you going to make the kebab? You want to find a cook, a chef locally. You want some equipments, certain processes to be done. Now, this is how you proceeded, right? Now, this is the way most of us would start thinking about our startup. Okay. And I won't say it is wrong, but the preferred way of thinking is the other way around. That is starting with the why and not the what. Okay. Starting with the why and not the what. If you want to arrive at a good brand statement for your startup, start with the why. Now, what is the why? Why defines your purpose. Okay, your purpose for existence as a startup. Now, purpose for existence of a startup is not making money alone. It is something more than that. Now, let me come to someone else. Now, if I come to Thiruvasagam, what is the purpose with your startup? Why do you exist?
Yeah, easily get motors from directly contact the manufacturer.
Okay.
Bulk orders.
Like. Make bulk order of motors easy for the clients? Yes?
Yes, sir. Yes. Easily they can comparison.
Okay. So they can compare between them. So what is your purpose? Why do you exist? In the market, if I should ask you like that, why do you exist? Now there is an India Mart that exists. There are some other portals that may exist, but why do you exist among them all? Why should they come to you?
They are not preferring all those manufacturers. They only particularly pick some manufacturers, topmost manufacturers. I am preferred to local manufacturers also. That's my total plus point.
Purpose. So your purpose, I would say, is to give a portal, to make a portal which will give visibility to small scale manufacturers of portals.
Enterprises also.
Yes. Exactly. And enterprises. So now that is the purpose. When you start with your purpose, and then proceed to your process and then proceed to what you would do. This is a better way of doing it rather than starting with the what context. What would I do? What would I make? What am I going to sell is secondary. Then why am I going to sell? Okay. Why am I going to sell is the primary thing. Now, why factor is, for example, if I would take Thiruvasagam's point of view, why are you going to do it? Okay. I may say from my perspective, he's going to make the life of all those motor manufacturers, small scale industries, and trying to compete with the big scale industries quite easy. He's going to give them a visibility,
opportunity
to come online and sell by competing with us, like OYO did. Like OYO did.
Of course, sir.
Small scale hotels. Okay. Now, this is the same purpose. So, why do you exist is more important when it comes to a brand statement. Okay, so I believe all of you are clear about it. Okay, Simon Sinek, so you should start with the why. Okay. If you take an example of any brand statement that companies have, they always define the why first. Let me take one example. Okay, and I want your genuine reply. Why does Karuni exist? Why does Karuni exist?
Human.
What is their brand statement?
Arise and shine.
Arise and shine is their tagline.
Moto.
What is the brand statement of Karuni presently? Which the chancellor speaks very often. Which the top management speaks quite often. What is the brand statement of Karuni? Why do they say Karuni exists? Karuni as a university exists. Yes. There's one statement, three-word statement that they say. Yes. Solving human problems, right? They say. Karuni University is a university with a social concern. And we are here to solve human problems.
Human problems.
And if you look at our chancellor, he also speaks a lot about it. Look at the top management, whether it is vice chancellor, registrar, they also talk a lot about it. All the conferences, workshops we conduct a lot about that same theme, solve human problems. When you look at the thrust area of Karunya, whether it is water, food, energy, all these areas talk about solve human problems.
Solve human problems.
So the founders of this institution, Karunya, they have actually made clear that we exist to solve human
problems.
In the same way, if you take any startup or any popular startup in the world, you'll always have a vision statement, okay, which is the purpose of their existence. And if you start with your purpose of your existence, your brand statement will become easier. Creating a brand statement will become easier for you. Because there are many different mobile phones. There are many hotel booking portals. There are many bus booking portals today. But why should they choose Redbus over others? Why should they choose Ola cabs over others? Why should they choose Apple iPhone over others?
They create a brand.
This can be done only when they create a perception in others' mind. Okay, about their brand. Okay. So it is not about what you sell, it is about how you make them feel when you sell it. Is it clear?
Trust factor.
Yes?
Trust factor.
Okay. When Bill Gates was asked, there's a very famous quote which goes like this: if they like you, they will listen to you. Okay. But they will do business with you only if they trust you. Okay. So in business world, if they like your product, they like your talking and everything, it's good. They will listen to you. But only they will do business with you when they trust you. How do you bring that trust factor? You see many portals saying, we assure you this service, right? Because this assurance factor. Whether you go to Make My Trip, they say about assured. Make My Trip assured hotel booking. Okay, there is certain hotels, they would say, we assure you this. If you go to Alibaba.com, that day Thiru Asagam was discussing with me, every transaction you make over there is, they give an assurance from their side. Okay, but that is a trust factor you built. Okay. So that is what a Simon Sinek circle. Is it clear to all of you? Any doubt on this? Hello? Anybody has any doubt on Simon Sinek circle?
Yes.
Hello?
Hello?
You're back, right?
Sir, all okay. Okay.
Any doubt in this?
No, sir.
No. Okay, so now can you see the screen? Define your values.
No, sir.
Are you all able to see that screen? Yes?
Yes.
Yes. Now, define your values is actually an exercise that all of you need to do. It's about your companies and the values you are going to have with respect to your business. Okay. Yeah. Can you give an example of a value that you're going to have in your business?
Help small enterprises to be
small enterprises. Okay. So market. So in market, what values do you want to carry? Like integrity. Okay.
Truthfulness.
Okay.
Punctuality.
Now that is personal value. Okay. Okay. Now to give you a good idea about the values, let me show you one screen. Okay, let me show you. Okay. What values certain startups create? Okay, if you go to any company, now Tata is one of the most trusted brand in our country, right? Yes?
Yes, sir.
If it is after value government, we trust anything, it is about Tata, right? Yes, it's a brand that we all trust. Now, if you go to Tata and you just check about them, they speak about their values and purpose. And if you see their values here itself, it speaks about integrity, responsibility, excellence, pioneering, and unity. Okay. And they say Tata, if you go on reading below it, they say Tata exists to fulfill their values. Now, when they're doing this, are they speaking about a product? Are they speaking about their service? No. Okay. They don't talk about their product or service. What they talk about? The value and the purpose of their existence. Okay, Tata is actually starting with the why factor. Okay, if you look at Reliance Industry and another big industry in our country, okay, if you look at their about us page also, you see our values and behavior. What are they talking about? Customer value is there. One of the highest values they choose. Excellence in their service. Team ownership, ownership mindset, respect, integrity, all of these are their values they follow. Well, look at some new startups like Swiggy. You see the values they say about consumer comes first, strive for excellence, be honest, display highest levels of integrity, etc. If you look at some other startups, okay, so these are the values that these startups or this company's project. If you look at Oyo Rooms, what are they talking about? Now, what is Oyo Rooms about? It's booking a room, right? But if you look at their portal, they say it's living the good life. Now, what does living the good life has to do with room booking, right? So, but they are talking that you book a room at Oyo and you can live a comfortable life. Now, if you keep on going on there, this thing, you see their brand statements are very perfect. We have perfected the art of reviving old, worn down properties and injecting in them the new Oyo style. They talk about the purpose of their existence. Look at Ola Cabs.
Ola.
They say redefining mobility for billions. When you look in all these startups, whether it is young startups like Swiggy, Ola, or Oyo, or whether it is legendary industries like Tata and Reliance, you see they are all talking about their values, their purpose, the why factor. Okay, they are not talking about their what factor or how factor. So coming back to our statement again, okay, let me share that screen with you. Okay, what is more important is not about what you do or how you do it. What is more important is why you do it.
Why you do it.
Okay. So if I should ask you, why are you studying engineering? Okay. That is more important than how you're going to study it and what degree you're going to get it. Okay. So I want to encourage all of you to define your values, put the values that are important for your startup. Okay. I believe this is also one of the assignments. Okay. And start with the first value, the most important value to the least important values. Okay. Is it clear? Okay. Now, when you put this, you'll have a very good idea about how to define your brand statement. That was the entire reason for having this session. Okay. Having this session about creating a brand statement. Okay. So just revising the topic. So what is the brand?
Without your presence here, somebody would create.
So what's the brand?
Your brand?
So what is quality. That? It's a quality, okay?
Of,
it's an image. It's an image of your
okay. Image
of your product or services in the eyes of the customer. Very important, the eyes of the customer. Okay. So that is basically a brand. And how do you make it? How do you make your brand statement? How do you do it? By using these two tools, that is Simon Sinek's Golden Circle Principle and this Define Your Values tool. Okay. So when you use this tool, ask yourself a question. Why should your startup exist? Why should Redbus exist? Why should Ola exist? Why should Swiggy exist? Their founders had this why factor very clear in their mind. That's why they are successful today. Okay. You also should have this why factor very clear in your mind. And then define the values that you hold dear to and will not compromise with. Okay. And prioritize your value. Okay. For example, for Swiggy, their first value is customer come first. That means customer service is their topmost priority value. Then comes the value about punctuality, timeliness, services, least cost services, and all those things. Okay. So what is the most important value that will define your startup? Put it on the top. And they define the others. Okay. Is that clear to you? Any questions?
Yes.
Any question, guys?
Yes, sir.
So was it interesting? This topic, was it interesting to you? Will it be useful for you to create a brand statement?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah?
Absolutely, sir.
Okay. So I would suggest you to use this quarantine time very fruitfully. Okay. Think about a good startup idea. Okay. And think about creating a brand statement. Okay. Remember, the purpose of your existence should be clearly defined before you start thinking about what you would do and how would you do it. Okay, that's the basic thing that that's the entire purpose of this session that we have. Okay, the purpose of your existence is very important. Then the services and the products you offer. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Any questions?
No, sir.
Okay. If you have any questions, okay, put it on the WhatsApp group. Okay. If possible, I've recorded this session and I'll share a link of the same with you. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for joining.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for taking some time off your quarantine.
Bro, corona, corona, go.
No problem.
It's India corona.
Okay. Okay, guys, take care of yourself. Okay.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Home outside.
Take care. You take care, okay. Sir.
Take care of your health.
Bye, sir.
Okay. Okay then. Bye.
Bye. Hello.